It's the 18th of July, and there's much to celebrate at Addis Ababa Bole, Ethiopia's largest airport. Passengers are about to board a flight to Asmara, the capital of neighbouring Eritrea, something that's been quite unthinkable since war broke out here in 1998. In a shiny white dinner jacket stands Prophet Serafel Demissier, a Pentecostal preacher who fasted for 40 days in the hope that peace would come. Nearby stand women wrapped in the traditional white shawl of Highland Ethiopia and Eritrea, a symbol of their shared culture. Eritrea and Ethiopia, bound by blood, language and history, have been trapped in a tragic, frozen conflict for the best part of two decades. But a peace deal signed in July sends waves of excitement through the region as phone lines are restored and flights resumed. As the Boeing 787 ascends to the clouds, singing breaks out. Champagne is uncorked in the aisle, while overjoyed passengers receive cakes and roses. Some come to sniff out business opportunities in a land so closed off from the outside world that it's been called Africa's North Korea. For the sons and daughters, husbands and wives, brothers and sisters separated two decades ago, arriving in Asmara is an even more magical moment. Eritreans embrace their estranged neighbours on the tarmac. A sea of well-wishers crowd the gates, some breaching them in their excitement. An Ethiopian woman hugs a tearful father she hasn't seen in more than 20 years. Africa's longest war is at an end, and with peace comes prosperity, though much remains uncertain. All of the Horn of Africa will be more stable if this most intractable rift heals.